So again, one of the things that we turned to was trying to understand the spiritual essence or the significance of that experience. Again, on one hand, you could have seen it humanly as overexposure to the sun. But, as you might be getting used to, there's a passage here in the glossary that also helps understand a different context of the sun. And that passage reads, "It's the symbol of soul governing man, of life, truth, and love." So one of the things that we wanted to focus on was, spiritually, what is our relationship to what we think of as the sun? It's a symbol. It's a symbol of soul governing man. We know that the sun, from a physical standpoint, is an incredible source of life and of energy. And I suspect that's what the author means in terms of a symbol. You know, one of the things about this process of scientific translation is that it's not simply trying to say that the material elements of the environment equal the divine presence. The process of spiritual translation means that you go from a physical perception of something and try to see its spiritual meaning or essence. When you do that, then you begin to find an entirely different scenario. It goes back to perhaps what Jesus was seeing when he quelled that storm. And he asked that question, "Why are you so afraid?" We wouldn't be afraid of the environment if we understood its spiritual significance and nature. We also wouldn't misuse the environment if we understood its significance and its spiritual nature. Because in addition to showing us how we can live creatively and harmoniously with it, it also shows us more of the divine nature. It is, when seen from a spiritual perspective, is the evidence of this divine nature. So our responsibility to the environment then becomes not so much one out of simply a moral demand to be more careful about the physical things around us, but a willingness to see differently what is around us. And in so doing, to be able to gather from what we see that understanding that allows us to see the potential, to see the resources, to see the prospects of what life living in accord with nature really is about. You know, Mary Baker Eddy has a rather interesting statement in Science and Health about the impact of our thought on experience. She says, "The physical universe expresses the conscious and unconscious thought of mortals." It's been my experience over the years that there is a great deal of truth to that. I've especially seen that in my interaction on my ranches over the years, especially with animals, that they express the conscious or unconscious thought held about them. But I've also seen that in terms of impact on crops, that they too, as a life expression, express the conscious and unconscious thought about them. So maybe one of the things that we can begin appreciating about our interaction with the environment is that, again, this environment has to be understood as something more than the aggregate of physical elements. That we need to understand its mental nature, and we need to understand our responsibility to thinking about it actively or creatively. The challenges that face our environment are significant on the human scene. But they are also solved and are solvable by a change of attitude and a change of approach. Because inevitably, what that will bring to light is a deeper recognition of what is available to us, what resources we have, and how we can more effectively use them. So, when you're thinking about your prayer in the environment, I hope you will do something more than just pray about the environment and hope that it will change, or hope that other people might change in terms of their interaction with it, or maybe other entities. Most effective way of accomplishing change is finding ways of letting our desires for our prayer be reflected in our lives. So, the challenge I would give each one of you this evening is in the next day or so to try to shift your perspective from what it is that you have and how it is serving you to understanding it as a resource and a potential for resolution of some need in your experience. If you live those convictions, if you live that emphasis on seeing differently the things around you and what are available to you, you will find that your prayer makes a significant difference to our environment. Thanks for coming.
I'll be happy to take a couple of questions if anyone has something they'd like to ask.
How did your friend with a sunburn turn out?
That's a good question. You know, when I give these stories, sometimes I don't give the punchline. What she found was by changing her perspective that situation began to recede, and eventually she became symptom-free, healed of that.